In terms of your work at Facebook, what are some recent projects that you've been working on?
So one thing I'm really fascinated by is how information flows through networks. So in my early work, this was just how web pages link together. But with online social networks being such a prevalent means of communicating these days, there's a lot of transmission from individual to individual, from individual to their social network. And there are these things called memes, which are ideas that seem to almost take advantage of this to replicate themselves. So some Facebook status updates, for example, will have a little piece of text that says copy and paste or repost or post this so that all your friends will see if you agree with this statement. One interesting thing about memes is that they tend to recur over time. So sometimes you see a meme and it's like, oh yeah, I saw that one a year ago. Now it's back. And how does it come back? So we looked at one particular meme. This is the money bags meme, which says that, you know, this year, October has five Fridays, Saturdays, Sundays. This happens only once every 823 years, and this is a lucky occurrence, blah, blah, blah. And anyone who actually looks it up sees that this kind of occurrence is much more frequent. And in fact, you'll have different variants of the meme. For example, here in red, you have the one that says July has five Fridays, Saturdays, Sundays, and this is true in 2011. And if you just look at this plot, which will, on a linear scale, show you the counts for this meme, it may appear as though it just disappears completely in between. So you might think, well, maybe it's being introduced from some other source and not Facebook. But the weird thing is that the meme is adapted to Facebook. It says copy and paste, which doesn't make so much sense for other media. So is it possible that the meme is actually staying within Facebook but in very low numbers and then flares up? And so if you, instead of using a linear scale, use a log scale, here at the same time you can see counts that are 100,000 and counts that are 10. And so here when you look, you can see that even though there's a rapid decay in interest, it actually looks like it's maybe power law. And you can see the meme persisting in low numbers, and then different variants perhaps being prompted by a resurgence of this meme then subsequently occurring. These were done in ggplot, just with a simple line geom and grouping by the particular meme variant, and then rescaling the y-axis to log in one of the versions.